In this video, we'll talk about BCD numbers and their importance relating to 8051. When we interact with microcontroller, we input hexadecimal numbers, and microcontroller does its operations in binary and it outputs result in hexadecimal. But we humans are not very comfortable in using hexadecimal numbers. Rather, we find it more easier to use decimal numbers. Microcontroller does provide a way to use decimal numbers, but not directly through the use of BCD numbers. BCD, which is the abbreviation of binary coded decimal. These are the decimal numbers, but they are coded in binary. Let us take an example and see how it is done. Let us take 10 in decimal and say I want to represent it in binary coded decimal. First, we'll represent it in binary. We all know how to represent decimals in binary. Binary equivalent of 10 is 1010. And now I want to represent this decimal in BCD. I'll take individual bit, I'll take 0, and I represent it in binary but using 4 digits. I'll take 0 and represent it in binary but using 4 digits. I write 4 zeros. Later I'll take 1 and I represent it in binary but using 4 digits, which is nothing but 0001. This is the BCD equivalent of 10. How easy is that? Next, take one more example. Say 36. This is in decimal, and we all know how to represent 36 in binary, which is 00100100. This is the binary equivalent of 36. And now, if I want to represent it in decimal in BCD, that can be done as I'll take 6 and I represent 6 in binary but using 4 digits, which is 0110. Next, I'll take 3 and I represent it in binary using 4 digits, which is 0011. This is the BCD equivalent of 36. Basically, we have only 10 numbers in BCD format, which are 0, 1 till 9. 0 can be represented as 0000, and 1 can be represented as 0001. Like this, 9 can be represented as 1001. These are the only 10 different numbers that are available in BCD format. If I want to represent a number that is greater than 9, that is done using the combinations of these numbers. For example, say if I want to represent 85, this is in decimal and I want to represent it in BCD, that can be done. We know how to represent 5 in BCD and we know how to represent 8 in BCD. We will write one number next to other that makes 85. If I want to represent 5, with the BCD equivalent of that is 0101, and the BCD equivalent of 8 is 1000. This is the BCD equivalent of 85. This is how it is done. In case of microcontroller 8051, we know that it is an 8-bit microcontroller. The registers are of 8-bit, and the maximum number the register can hold is 99. This is because I need 4 bits to represent 9, 1001. I need 4 more bits to represent 9, 1001. if I want to represent a number that is greater than 99. Take for example 100. If I want to represent 100 in BCD, that can be done as I'll take this 0 and I write 4 zeros. I'll take this 0, I'll write 4 more zeros. I'll take 1, I'll represent it like this. This is the BCD equivalent of 100. But if we observe closely, it takes 12 different bits. So, 8051 being an 8-bit microcontroller, it cannot store 12-bit number. So, 99 is the maximum number a register in 8051 can hold. This was about the introduction of BCD numbers and their importance relating to 8051.